thanks very much here from The Hague in the Netherlands. It's very good to be here at this exciting summit, really an interesting start for Gaia-X. And it's great to be part of that. And what I would like to do in the next few minutes is take you through our journey in the smart connected supplier network. So I'm working for TNO, which is a research innovation organization. And we've been working in the past years with several high-tech manufacturers when it comes to digitalization and data sharing. And maybe you think, okay, high-tech manufacturing, what is that about? Really, for me, it's about the beginning of everything digital. And you see that in this particular machine. Probably you will not recognize it, but this is a lithography machine. It's produced by ASML, European company. And this is the machine you need if you want to build the latest generation of microchips, which are faster, more energy efficient, and which are part of your new cell phone or your car. And they're the market leader in this. And this, for me, exemplifies what manufacturing or where Europe is good at in manufacturing. Highly complex machines. And they're not the only ones. We've seen Philips in the previous discussion, Jeroen Tas of Philips Healthcare, making similarly complex equipment. For instance, medical scanners used by doctors and hospitals across the world. And there are other examples of that as well. And this high-tech equipment is characterized by three words. They are, first of all, very complex machines. They are produced really for the individual needs of a manufacturer or of a customer. So as an example, last year, ASML shipped only 31 of those machines I just showed you. And well, that's the third word. It's also in low volume. So high complexity, high mix, and low volume. And that's a typical supply network where we are good at in Europe. And if you look back in time, let's say in the 1990s of the previous century, then this was how that supply network looked like, or how that value chain of a typical high-tech OEM looked like. They did research and development, the design and engineering, the prototyping and industrialization. And then when it came to component production, they went to their suppliers and they said, okay, these are the standardized parts or components which we need. And then they integrated that into their systems and did the further sales and service. That was what the value chain looked like. And with the increase in complexity of those machines, this has evolved over time. So the beginning of the century, this century, I mean, it moved towards the outsourcing of complete sub-assemblies. So complete parts of these highly complex machines were outsourced to suppliers. And those suppliers became more involved in that. They needed to think about the supply chain management, about their sourcing strategies, about the process development, and everything what was needed there. And also the number of organizations involved increased significantly. And in recent years, this has evolved further. So this is the picture we see today. Suppliers are involved for pretty much everything to build these highly complex machines. Business model development, quality, project management, the whole supply chain management. And there is a multi-tier structure of manufacturing companies involved. And this is the world we've been in for the past few years. We've worked with many organizations who are either an OEM or a first tier, a second or a third tier supplier in this network. And they say, if we want to be effective, if we want to simply be able to build these very complex machines, if you want to be part of this supply network, digitalization and data sharing is key. If we don't have digitalization, if we don't have data sharing, this will effectively not work. So we talked to them a lot about what challenges they see. And some of these challenges, particularly, for instance, for SMEs, were quite easy. They said, well, building components for this complex equipment means that I need to be able to receive digital designs and orders from my customer and process them in my own systems. And that creates an administrative burden. These are products in a high mix and a low volume. So it will also mean that I have a risk for errors. And if you have a low volume, a single error can have high consequences, especially if we're talking about this very complex equipment. Some of it were more on a strategic level. They said, well, we want to adapt to market changes much quicker. So if there is a demand, for instance, in Asia, which we saw in the semiconductor industry, where they need new equipment, and if a company like ASML is going to sell more equipment, then we as a supplier need to be able to meet that demand. So have a faster time to market and also then a faster time to money. And in recent years, it's all about resilience. We've seen the problems in the logistic chain with the Suez Canal. The prices of raw materials, they go up. We're seeing shortages in components, and that is affecting the high-tech supply chain as well. So you want to have visibility and transparency, and you want to be able to be notified about any issues which might occur, so you might be able to circumvent them or redress them. And overall, they said to us, well, if we are going to share more data to enable this, we think that we can make this supply network work at least 20% more efficient. And that's huge. Again, we're talking about complex machinery and very high turnovers. So a 20% efficiency gain is really something which can make and break your competitiveness. And then we said, okay, what is the needed on the digital side? Well, we need to have all the data. We want a platform through which we can more or less connect once and then communicate with all the stakeholders involved. And now the problem is, and this is also where high-tech manufacturing is maybe slightly different from some other areas, is that those partners can be different all the time because of this low volume and this high mix of products. Yet still, all the time, you need to connect the OEM, the first tier, the second tier, the third tier, wholesalers, and so on. So we need large scale, and we need many different business services, but in every case, we need to connect once and communicate with the entire supply network. And then you might say, okay, but solutions are available to do that, right? I mean, there are all the centralized platforms available. And this is also something which we have discussed with those companies. And they said no, because there is one key ingredient missing, and that's data sovereignty. Because if we, as an entire supply network, put all our data onto one platform, that's simply not viable. Not viable from a cybersecurity point of view, not viable from a competition point of view. And we fear the risk that this will introduce unwanted, unnecessary platform business models, which are often based on the principle of winner takes all. So we need a more federated approach. We need to make sure that data sovereignty is in place. So this was our starting point. And we did that as T&O. We discussed this with many of those manufacturing companies. Second initiator here was Brainport Industries. Brainport Industries is the sector organization representing over 100 high-tech suppliers active in the supply chains I just showed you. And together we have founded the Smart Connected Supplier Network, which is currently a key business case in Gaia-X. So, what do? We are actually building what we call a collaborative digital twin of the supply network. Depending on the case you can have, sometimes you need to share data of your manufacturing equipment, its capabilities, quality measurements you do, and so on. And for that, we are working with people in the domain of Industry 4.0, for instance, with the Asset Administration Shell, a new standard to build digital twins of manufacturing equipment. And we take that into account. On top of that, we're looking more at the logistics view and the supply chain view. So we are talking about, for instance, product data. Think of 3D designs with all kinds of manufacturing data included. We're talking about warehousing. We're talking about logistics. We're also talking about the products in use, because in many cases, we need to take care of those products during their entire lifetime, their entire life cycle. And on top of this, we have built a network of, first of all, manufacturing companies, so OEMs, first tier, second tier, third tier. We're really talking about hundreds of manufacturing companies here, and the whole network of service providers, which provide connectivity to those organizations, as well as value-added services. And for some organizations, this is quite straightforward and low level with, for instance, electronic purchasing and e-invoicing, which can already make a lot of difference for SMEs. But we also have more advanced services, for instance, for supply chain resiliency or for logistics collaboration. And we could only do this through a tailored business approach. As said, we cannot work with a single platform or a winner-takes-all. We need to have a more federated approach, and that's depicted in this picture. So for us, it begins here in the middle with some agreements. Agreements on the semantics, which are specific to this domain. By the way, we also work together with other initiatives there, as said, for instance, in the area of Industry 4.0. And we said we need to have horizontal standards, standards which work across domains for large-scale sovereign data sharing. And we started with international data spaces, also talked about today during the summit, and this is now evolving towards Gaia-X. And we've set up a foundation, the Smart Connected Supplier Network Foundation, a non-profit association, and that is simply managing the agreements. So for the horizontal standards, we simply refer to the work done in Gaia-X and IDS. You take care of that. We are closely working with you on that. And then together with the manufacturing organizations and the domain-specific organizations, we are looking at what is now specific for this domain. Think of the semantics of the data which is being exchanged. So that's the foundation. That's the core. Then we have service providers, and we ask all these service providers to adhere to those specifications. And in a way, they work like a telco. So even if you have a different telco than I have, as long as we have our telephone number, we can communicate with one another. So as long as these service providers adhere to the rules which are specified by the Smart Connected Supplier Network Foundation, they are able to communicate with each other. It's a federated approach, and it enables us to build a large offering of different services and different service providers, some more simple, some more complex, but it enables you as a manufacturing company to choose the service provider which fits your needs. So maybe it's just on purchasing, or maybe you want to do more quality data exchange, or you may want to do product lifecycle management with your partners. You choose the service provider which suits your needs. You make a one-off integration with them, so you make sure that there is a connection to their services, and it's integrated with your own, for instance, ERP or PLM or other manufacturing systems. But once you have done that, you can connect with everyone in the network. So this brings the best of two worlds. It enables us to have this key requirement: connect once and communicate with the entire network. But at the same time, it also provides us with this federated approach. There is not a single point where all the data is. It is distributed over the network, and everybody can control who gets access to this network. And this is oil staining rapidly at the moment. So if you look at the service providers, and if you go to our website, smart-connected.nl, you will find a list of them. We now have a dozen of those service providers. There are some Dutch companies. There are some other international operating companies. They are connected. They have an agreement with the foundation, and they have a simple commercial drive to attract new manufacturing companies. They are commercial companies. They want to put this service on the market, and they go to potential new manufacturing companies to connect them to the ecosystem. On the other hand, there are the manufacturing companies. They have a one-off integration, so they connect once to this network, and then for them that's done. But they too have a natural drive, because they too have an incentive to connect more customers and more suppliers to the network. So they will say to their customers and to their suppliers, if you want to do business with us in a digital way, this is the way to do it. So from two ends, this is really growing our business at the moment. So we are talking about a dozen service providers at the moment and hundreds of manufacturing companies, and we expect that to grow further in the next few years. And we're very pleased 2 weeks ago with NTT, the major Japanese telco, which has also announced that they would like to explore to take a bridge between what is happening here in Europe and what they are doing in Japan in their data space. And they have announced that they also want to become a service provider in the smart connected supplier network. So that's really exciting news, how this business ecosystem is growing. And that brings me to my call to action for the Gaia-X community. And I'm also happy to take some questions after this. So first is, work with us to introduce new smart manufacturing services. We've started in this high-tech domain, as you've seen, with semiconductor equipment, with medical equipment. But these organizations, they're also active, for instance, in aerospace or automotive and some other domains. And we've also noticed that the concepts which we have developed here also apply if you're working a bit further down in the supply chain. So for instance, we're working with Tata Steel on steel making, which they again sell to automotive customers. And I would like to extend that invitation to others as well. So you can work with us. These standards are available. It's an open initiative. It's a non-profit initiative. And we are very open for further collaboration there. Secondly, and that's actually a call to action for all the tech providers in our community, is that these kinds of initiatives require horizontal data sharing solutions, generic data sharing solutions. Think of the secure gateways, the federated catalogs, and so on and so forth. All the infrastructural components we need in Gaia-X. We will not fully develop them from this particular business case, because this is generic technology. And we also would like to make a link to other verticals. So it is important that we will have in the future a commercial offering of these data sharing solutions, and then we are happy to incorporate those. And I'm very glad to see that Gaia-X is providing us with the specifications for that. And finally, we're talking about data sovereignty. We're talking about lots of technological things here. But let's also keep our focus on business adoption. For me, the most important thing is that at the end of the day, I can say that we have helped hundreds of manufacturing companies to become more competitive, to save costs, to have more a better product in their supply network. And that's what we're doing together with Brainport Industries as a sector organization. Like TNO, they are now also a member of Gaia-X. And together with BMW, they are leading the Gaia-X initiatives on manufacturing. And similarly, as TNO, we're doing that on a regional level. So within the Netherlands, we are forming the Gaia-X hub to communicate these messages and also to provide this as an example to others to set up new data spaces in their domain. So with that, I would like to give the floor back to you in, I think it was Milan, if I'm not misunderstanding, somewhere in the cloud at least. And I'm also happy to take some questions.
So the first question is, smart connected supply network is a vertical use case, data sharing and manufacturing supply chains. Which horizontal data sharing cloud services are needed?
Well, good question. And this was actually also in my last slide. We need those services. So what are they? Well, manufacturing companies, or companies in general, I think they need, for instance, the secure gateways to connect their own organizations and their own IT systems with the cloud, so data can flow from the shop floor, manufacturing, or in a manufacturing plant, into the cloud, and then can become part of larger data sharing solutions. As a foundation, we require, for instance, this federated catalog, so all these service providers are able to find each other. Those are the kinds of things we need, and I think this applies to our ecosystem, but similarly, it will apply to other ecosystems as well. And this makes that there is also a business case to come up with those solutions.
On a second question, is this just for high tech, or can it also connect to other domains?
Yeah, excellent question. So we started in high tech because we saw that there was, here in the Netherlands, an immediate need for that. There was this administrative burden and so on and so forth. So we started there. But for instance, currently in the board of directors of the Smart Connected Supply Network is also the Dutch Metal Union, the Metaal Unie, which is the sector organization for the metal processing industry in the Netherlands. They have 14,000 members, and they're not only active in high tech, they're also active in construction, in agriculture, and well, pretty much any domain where you need metal products. So they say, we're part of this high-tech supply chain, but let's see how we can adapt those concepts and use them in other manufacturing supply chains as well. And well, that's actually happening today.
And a final question, what is the current status of the Smart Connected Supply Network? Can companies, in fact, join in?
Yeah, I would like to recall a remark that Boris Otto made. He said, we often talk about use cases. And I also was asked a lot of times in the past few years, is this a use case? Well, in a way you could say it's a use case, but it is also a business case. So this foundation is there. It's not some imaginary thing. It's an operational foundation. It is managing those specifications. The service providers, they are there. They're out there. And they have these services on the market. So in that sense, yes, this is an operational business case. Nevertheless, there is, I think, a huge potential to further grow it. Because for many organizations, it starts with simple purchase to pay. So of all these hundreds of organizations, I think most of them, they just start with purchase to pay. But other services need to be there as well. For supply chain resiliency, for capturing your product data footprint, for product lifecycle management, and so on and so forth. So yes, it is operational, but for us, also as TNO, this is really also a stepping stone towards new business cases and new initiatives using the Smart Connected Supplier Network as a basis.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
It was a pleasure. Pleasure to meet you, even virtually. I hope we do have the chance to meet in person. So I would like to take the opportunity to see if any of our physical attendees here at the event have any further questions for, yes, absolutely, here.
So, hi. Thanks very much for the interesting presentation. A few hours ago, we had a presentation of Katina X, and I'm pretty sure that you're aware of that. What would be your vision or idea of a successful collaboration between those two initiatives, as you're also tracking down the OEMs to the supplier level?
Yeah, for me, at the end of the day, all those initiatives, they need to work together. And the first starting point for that is to use a common technological basis. And that's, for me, Gaia-X. So as long as we make sure that, in our case, all the service providers adhere to those specifications, and the same is happening in Katina X as well, then you have a basis for further collaboration. Now, already today, many partners are both part of the automotive supply network and the high-tech supply network. So, and those discussions have already started, if we have the technology in place, then that is the perfect starting point for further collaboration. To grow the business, to increase the number of manufacturing companies which are connected. But for me, it starts with the technology here. We need horizontal standards across different domains for data sharing. That is also a promise for Gaia-X. If we have that in place, then I think the collaborative business cases will come up. But even if there still need to be some steps to be taken there, we already have some collaborations with Catena-X.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Thank you very much for your excellent presentation. May I ask the identical question I just asked a couple of hours ago to Catena-X? How can we motivate to become, again, I would like to cite again Boris, not having use cases, but really transferring them to business cases? How were you able to create these business cases? And what are the hints for the many, many hundreds of other use cases around the world, I repeat myself, not only in Europe, to become really the business cases by that leveraging Gaia-X, these base principles we are founding on, and by that scaling it up?
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on that?
Well, from our experience, how we started the Smart Connected Supply Network was not by just talking about all the technological stuff, but really about the business problems. So what are really now the business problems you are facing? That's one thing. Second thing is that you need to do that in a collaborative way. So, and that was actually a position we could take as an independent research organization, is that we could bring together different manufacturing companies, and we noted that they had the same problems. Second step was to go to the technology providers. I mean, the technology providers, they're there. They're out there, right? And that was the case back then, and it is the case now. And we said, this is the shared problem of your customers and potential customers. So work with us to create a solution for that. So that was the second ingredient. And then the third ingredient, and I think that was actually pretty critical, was that we were able to show that by doing this, in this federated approach, which we now call Gaia-X, that actually they could scale their business much faster than they would be able to do it through in the traditional way with the winner-takes-all model. And that the added value for, in this case, the high-tech manufacturing companies was much higher if we did it in this way. So with these three ingredients, starting with real end-user needs, bringing them together, make sure that the technology players are on board, and also showing that this federated approach can scale the solution much faster than they would be able to do in the past. That really helped us to start the Smart Connected Supply Network, and I think that applies to many other use cases as well. So hopefully that answers your question.
Thank you very much. Do we have any further questions? Okay, if not, thank you, Matisse. It was a pleasure.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much.
It was a pleasure.